أستاذ فورتي ناين ميل بيشنت بريزنت وذ ألتر ليفل أوف كونشيسنس أند فوميتينج. This corona life care. This is after contrast.
أنوار يعني انوار ماكو انفصل البنات عندها انوار عباس صابرين
نعم أستاذ، صباح الخير.
صباح الخير هلا صابرين ايش تشوفين صابرين؟
دكتور area of abnormal طبعا multiple section MRI showing area of abnormal signal intensity cortical and subcortical bilateral in bilateral frontal lobe which is hyper intense in FLIR and T2 and hypo in T1 non enhancing. دكتور إذا سمحتي شوفين ال MRV، هاي مسوي ال MRV.
نعم دكتورة.
بس حاول شوي يعني تقلبين. اوكي استاذ، مالتيبل فيلينج ديفكت ان سوبيريور ساجيتال ساينس as shown in this 3D MRV. This is يعني the case with the abnormal signal intensity الموجودة بالبرين بارانكيما، يعني mostly of superior sagittal sinus thrombosis. وإذا تمشي حتى ويا الـ يعني الهيستوري مال البيشنت اللي هو مثلا يعني altered consciousness و vomiting، زين هو عنده هيستوري دكتورة مال مثلا يعني ياخذ فد دراكس معينة أو
دكتورة يعني coagulopathy history عنده؟
إيه أيوه، ولهذا يعني حتى الهيستوري مالته ده يمشي ويا الكيس أستاذ.
شكرا صابرين.
شكرا أستاذ.
سجاع عامر.
نعم أستاذ، صباح الخير.
صباح الخير يا سجاع.
Multiple section MRI there is abnormal signal in the باراساجيتال ريجين بايلاترال بارايتال وبالكونتراست هم شفت اكو فيلنج ديفكت بالسوبيريور ساجيتال ساينس. بس دكتوره اذا مسويه سوي حتى نشوف اسوشيتد هيموراج اكثر الفينوس انفراكشن تكون اسوشيتد وذ هيموراج.
دكتورة ما مسوين يعني بس دوي و اي دي سي
طالعين دوي يعني سوي جريديت ما مسوين
إذا ما عدنا سوي ولا جريديت شو راح نشوف حتى نشوف
التي 1 تي 1 مثلا اذا هاي سيجنال
تي
1 بس هو بالتي 1 ما طلع واضح شو يعني تي 1 ارضيه مره ثانيه يعني شفته بالتي 1 يعني ها هاي يعني هاي بوسيمان مو هاي لو سيجنال انتنسيتي بس هو مرات حتى لو ما يبين بالتي 1 بس هو يبين الهيموراج من اغلبيه الفينوس انفراكشن يكون هيموراج
أغلبيتهم 1/3 بس هيمولوجي.
تمام أستاذ.
أنتو دكتورة؟
إيه شفت التيوان الدوي والأيدس.
أيدس.
رشا هذا الزيرو هذا الزيرو ما يفيدنا عبري على الوراء على
الالف طبعا الالف
ايه اكو ريستريكشن بي
يعني ما اكو ديش الهاي سيجنال انتنسيتي نفس المقارنة تطلع بالتي 2 بالفلير اقوى حطيهم سوا الدوي والاي دي سي ماكو ريستركشن
نعم فانت يعني مثل صابرين تقولين هاي دي فينوس ساينس ترومبوسيس
ايه سوبر ساتشتا ساينس ترومبوسيس والاسوشيتد فينوس انفراكشن
نعم
بس يعني ظاهر مو اكيوت حتى يعني ما صاير عابر انه مرحله يصير ريستركشن نعم استاذ
شكرا سجا يلا يا رشا احكي لنا على الكيس اذا عندك دكتور
نعم استاذ مثل ما تفضلوا الزملاء دكتور هي هايبر انتنسيتي مطرات اجت واضحه بالتي 2 اند فلير مطرات على بايلاترال اون بوث سايد اون سيربرال كونفكستي بالدوي والاي دي سي ما طلع اكو اري اوف ريستركشن بالام ار في ذير از مالتيبل ديفكت اريا سو دايجنوزز Diagnosed as a superior sagittal sinus thrombosis. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Cerebral venous thrombosis. Let's begin with the anatomy regarding the venous system of a brain. It is divided into superficial and deep. The superficial represented by the superior sagittal sinus. This is the superior sagittal sinus and at the confluence of the sinuses and the deep system beginning with the internal cerebral vein on both motor cerebral side, which unit below the subunion of the corpus callosum. together with the basal vein of Rosenthal will form the vein of Galen, which is in turn with the inferior sagittal sinus will form the striate medullary sinus that drain at the confluence of the sinus. This area is called the tercula. Then the transverse sinus on both sides, sigmoid sinus and the jugular vein. This is the CT venography. It is taken after 45 seconds after the contrast administration. This is the superior sagittal sinus. This is the striate sinus, vein of Galen, internal cerebral vein, and this is the inferior sagittal sinus. About the definition, it is referred to the occlusion of the venous channel in the cranial cavity, including the dural venous thrombosis, cortical vein thrombosis, and deep cerebral vein thrombosis. The predisposing factor in a neonate, it is mainly due to shock and dehydration. In older children, mainly due to infection such as the mastoiditis. In adult, mainly due to the coagulopathy, as in this case. In women, the oral contraceptable pregnancy are a major risk factor. The others, such as the sickle cell disease, COVID-19 vaccination, mostly AstraZeneca, and tumors with a dural invasion. The clinical presentation, it is a highly variable and range from asymptomatic to severe neurological deficit that end with coma and death. But the most common symptoms is the headache in 19% of cases after a level of consciousness, nausea and vomiting, and focal neurological deficit. About the radiographic feature, we have a direct sign of a thrombus and indirect sign of a thrombus. The direct sign of a thrombus, let's begin with the CT. We have a dense clot sign and cord sign. It is a hyperdense vein or sinus for the first 7 to 14 days in non-contrast CT. This is an accurate sign when present. We have also the empty delta sign. It is a falling defect after 45 seconds of giving contrast in a CT venogram. This is an important point. It is a falling defect. It should not be confused with the arachnoid granulation, which can be seen essentially in all the dural sinuses and are especially common in the superior sagittal sinus and the transverse sinus. The arachnoid granulation for the CSF signal intensity. These two pictures, native axial CT of a brain. On the right side, this is the dense clot sign, mainly due to medullary thrombosis in the cortical vein. This is picture also medullary native CT show dense clot in the superior sagittal sinus. This is the cross section of the sagittal sinus show dense clot. This is the axial CT with a contrast. This magnified picture, moderately show the superior sagittal sinus will take enhancement while internally there is a defect caused by thrombosis giving empty delta sign thrombosis of the superior sagittal sinus. In MRI, absence of normal flow void, it is best seen in the T2-whited and flare image. The clot acutely is iso on T1 and hypointense on T2. This can mimic a flow void with a subacute clot becoming hyperintense on T1. Cerebral edema can be identified even in absence of a neurological dysfunction or infarction. In MRV, it will demonstrate a lack of flow. The time of flight venography, it is routinely performed in suspected cases. Contrast MR venography is more sensitive in detecting a dural venous sinus thrombosis than the time of a flight venography. Hypoplastic dural sinus and low flow area remain a major problem with two-day time of flight. This is axial MRI. On the right side, this is the normal flow void in the right sigmoid sinus and jugular vein. Flow void because moderate of high flow. This is the normal moderate side. The left side, it is abnormal side, show a high signal as a result of the thrombosis. A high signal may occur as a result of slow flow. This is the transverse maximum intensity projection image of face contrast angiography. There is absence flow of the transverse sinus. This is a picture from the radiomedia with the clinical correlation diagnosed as the right transverse sinus thrombosis. This is absence of flow on this side. The indirect sign of thrombosis, it means ischemia or vascular changes related to venous outflow disturbance. In the superior sagittal, when the superior sagittal sinus thrombosis, the infarction occurs bilaterally parasagittal convexity of cortex, as in this case, when the infarction, when the thrombosis occurs in the deep vein system, the infarction occurs bilaterally at bilateral thalami. When in the transverse sinus thrombosis, the infarction occurs at posterior temporal loop. This diagram shows a venous territory when the thrombosis occurs in the deep internal cerebral vein or vein of Galen. So the area of ischemia occurs here, moderated bilaterally at the basal ganglia. Where the thrombosis occur in the superior sagittal sinus, this is the area of infarction occur bilaterally at the post-moderate cerebral convexity. This area, venous drainage moderate of vein of Lacti occur posteriorly to the Sylvian fissure. This is the Sylvian fissure, and this is the this area posterior. It is the venous drainage of vein of Lacti. This is axial moderate T2 MRI show bilateral parasagittal hyperintensity. This picture from the radio BDA diagnosed as a bilateral infarction in the superior sagittal sinus. It is occurred bilaterally at both moderate cerebral convexity. These two pictures, it is a titillated image and a flare, show there is area of hemorrhage. This is the area of infarction, and this is the area of hemorrhage. These area, this is the Sylvian fissure. So this area, it is occur posteriorly to the Sylvian fissure. So it is the area of vein of Lapi. So it is diagnosed as a hemorrhagic venous infarction in the Lapi territory. About the CT perfusion, although it is not routinely used routinely in clinical practice, whole brain CT perfusion may assist in establishing the diagnosis of the thrombosis by detecting a perfusion of normality that do not correspond with arterial territories. The angiography, also the digital subtraction angiography, has historically been the gold standard. The relative lack of experience in geographic skill and invasive nature of the examination has led to the dramatic decline in its use as a primary mode of diagnosing cerebral venous thrombosis. The, about the treatment, the mainstay of the treatment is a heparin, even in the setting of hemorrhagic venous infarction. The interventional management include microcatheter thrombolysis or thromboplasty. And thank you for all.